Okay, we're doing the Taylor tilt test. We're testing for the calcaneal fibular ligament. So I'm grasping just below the lateral malleolus and applying a medial tilting. So I'm testing the calcaneal fibular ligament. It runs between the calcaneus and the fibular head, or the distal part of the fibula. And here, doing a medial tilting, you're looking for excess movement, pain, discomfort of the lower foot here. Here we're doing Thompson's test. It's for rupture of the gastrocnemius, the soleus, or the Achilles tendon. What you want to do is take the gastrocnemius soleus and squeeze. What you should see is a plantar flexion of the foot, noting that it's normal. If you don't see the plantar flexion or it's very different from the unaffected side, you may consider that the Achilles has been ruptured. The other thing, the other logical thing to do is to palpate where the tendon is and feel if there's a bulge up into the posterior aspect of the calf and through here. You should feel a bulge if there is a rupture and there'd be a lack of tissue on the Achilles tendon compared to the unaffected side. Okay, we're doing a Holman sign, which is for a deep vein thrombophlebitis of the lower leg or calf. So what you want to do, first you want to take a look at the calf. If there's pallor, swelling, edema, compare the opposite side, there's no history of a sprained strain of a calf or a tear. If the person has been doing a lot of traveling and has poor circulation, you may consider that this might be a situation where they'll have to have it examined by a physician. So one of the ways to evaluate is to apply pressure to the bottom of the foot going into dorsiflexion. There usually will be an increase of pain with that, and palpation directly on the area should elicit discomfort and pain. So again, if there's pallor, swelling, edema, with no real history of a strain of the muscle or a calf or a tear compared to the opposite side, if the person has been traveling a lot of distance, has been in a cramped position, you may consider that this is a situation where they should seek immediate medical advice.